Hello students, welcome to module 17, and in this module I will be continuing the chapter of influence line diagram. Okay, now let us see this question. So yesterday we have done couple of questions related to ILD of the reaction, right? This question is also related to ILD of reaction, same last question which we have used. Instead of point load, now I am using UDL. Okay, so what is the question? In above question, that is the last question which you have solved, right? So a UDL of 5 kN per meter of length 3 meter is moving on a beam. Maximum reaction is so simple. So to get reaction, what you have to do? You have to remove the support first. That is the first step. And second step is lift it by 1 unit. Okay. So once you lift it, the deflected shape will be your ILD. So this is my ILD for this reaction A. Right. Now place your UDL such that you will be getting your maximum reaction. See, you can place at any point, right? You can place here, you can place here, it is up to you. But where should you place? To get your maximum reaction, obviously, where you have more area, right? This area, right? So what I told you, when we have a UDL, what we have to do to get reaction? We have to multiply the UDL load into area under it, right? So what is the area under it? Here it is 1 unit. Here, what is the coordinate? Let this be x. So this distance is 3 meters, right? So obviously this distance will be 7 meters. Agreed? So 1 divided by 10, if you use similar triangles, x by 7, right? Because this 1 divided by entire 10 is equals to x divided by this distance, which is 7. So what is your x value? 0.7. Okay, so I got the coordinate as 0.7. So I know it is a trapezoid now, something like this. So this is 0.7 and this is 1. So what is the area of trapezoid? A plus B by 2 into H. If this distance is H, right? Let this be A, let this be B. Okay, A plus B by 2 into H, right? So what is the area of triangle we will be getting? 1 plus 0.7 divided by 2 into what is the this length is 3 meters. So this is my answer. So I will be getting 1.7 by 2 into 3 into load. Load was 5 kN per meter. So if you multiply this, you will be getting 12.75 kN. So that will be your maximum reaction due to this UDL of 5 kN per meter of length 3 meters. Very simple, right? There is nothing much in this question. This note I have explained yesterday only. Very important note. Please never make mistake in it. Okay, let me solve one more question related to ILD of support reactions, and then I will go to ILD of shear force diagram. Okay, in this question it is quite simple. So a train of two point loads of 150 kN and 100 kN. So 150 and 100 spaced 5 meters apart. So the spacing is 5 meters crossing the beam shown in figure from left to right. Okay, so from left side they are going to the right side. Okay, in this diagram they are going from left to the right with 100 kN load leading. So this is my 100 kN load and this will be my 150 kN load. So find maximum and minimum reaction at support R. At what support you have to find? This support, at the support R. So I have a overhanging beam something like this. See, I am teaching you through the camera, right? So whenever I lift the left part, you will feel like I am lifting the right part. And whenever I am lifting the right part, you will feel like I am lifting the left part. Okay. So please be careful. I will be denoting it as well as camera. I will be denoting it on the paper also, right? So please concentrate more on the paper than on camera. Okay. So now please watch the camera. So let this be my Q point. Let this be my R point. Okay. So what I have to do to get the reaction at R, to draw the ILD for the reaction at R. So remove the support at R first and lift the R point by 1 unit. So my deflected shape will be something like this, right? At Q, it is not going up or down. It is a support. You should respect your support, right? It should not be disturbed at all. So it is something like this. Agreed? So it is something like this, very similar to this, right? At Q, we are not lifting or it is not going down. The overhang near the Q, it is going down, and the overhang near the R, it will be going up, obviously. So what will be the coordinates? Let us calculate the coordinates. You can use similar triangles. Okay, so R you are lifting by 1 unit and the distance between Q and R is 10 meters and the overhang is of 3 meters. So what should be this coordinate? So you can use similar triangles. 1 by 10 is equals to, if this is X, divided by this distance is 3, right? So you will be getting your x value as 3 by 10, which is nothing but 0.3. Similarly, you can use similar triangle for this triangle also. What you will be getting? 1 by 10 is equals to this distance is 10 plus 5. You can see 10, 5. 10 plus 5 is 15, right? So x divided by 15. Your x value is 15 by 10, which is 1.5. So I will be getting my coordinates now. So almost 90% of the problem is solved. 90% of the problem is solved because I got my ILD diagram. I know my values. Let me erase these ones. Now the most important point. Where should you keep the load to get your maximum and minimum reaction? So yesterday I told you the trick, right? So you should try at various positions. You should also keep your load in air. You should keep partial load in air and also check to whether you are getting some maximum or minimum values. Okay. So obviously to get maximum value, where you should keep the load? Just imagine this is 0.3 minus, right? It is going down. So obviously 0.3 is minus. It is plus 1.5. To get maximum value, where you should keep the load? Obviously at these points, right? You can keep like this. There are only two possibilities. I can keep like this, or I can keep 150 and 100 like this, or I can keep 150 at this and 100 outside and check. Whatever gives the maximum value, that will be my answer. And to get minimum, obviously I have minus value here. Obviously I have to keep my loading here, right? So I can keep it somewhere here, or I can keep outside also. I will check for various loading conditions and I will take it. Okay, so where am I keeping the first possibility? See, here I have already given possibilities. You can just see the notes beside it in your hard copy. So in the first possibility, I have keeping my 100 kilonewton load. Yeah, I have keeping my 100 kilonewton load, and 150 kilonewton load is still outside only. Okay, it is still on the ground only. For example, if I am talking about this overhang truss, right? Let us say this is my overhang beam. Okay, so it is something like this. This is my ground. Your train is moving from the ground to this beam. Okay, so this train has been represented by two wheels, right? So wheel one is 150 kilonewton, wheel two is 100 kilonewton. So I am just imagining 100 kilonewton load has entered this overhanging beam. Okay, so what will be my reaction? Vr will be the coordinate. So load is somewhere here, 100, and my coordinate is minus 0.3. So what should be my reaction? Minus 0.3 into 100, which will be minus 30 kilonewton. What is the second possibility? Second possibility is to get minimum reaction. You can keep your 150 kilonewton load here, and at the spacing of 5 meters, you have 100 kilonewton load. Okay, just multiply your load and the coordinates. What you will be getting? Just see, 150 into minus 0.3, which will be around 45, right? If I am not wrong, minus 45 plus this load. This is 2 meters apart, right? So obviously this will be 0.2. So 100 into 0.2, which will be 20. So you will be getting minus 25. Okay, what are the two possibility values we got? Minus 30 and minus 25. Which is the least in this? Minus 30 kilonewton is the least. So the minimum reaction you are getting is minus 30 kilonewton. So obviously you can eliminate two values, right? One, two. Two options you can eliminate. So two options are there. Now let us find what is the answer. Okay. So to get the maximum value, where should we keep? There are two possibilities. I can keep my 150 kilonewton load at the end point, and after 5 meters, that is in air, it doesn't consider, right? We can't consider it. So that will be 100 kilonewton. So this is one possibility, and second possibility is to keep my 100 kilonewton load here and 150 kilonewton load here. Okay, so what should be, let us see the possibilities first. So in the third possibility, I am keeping 150 kilonewton here and 100 kilonewton here. Okay, so just multiply it with the coordinates. So multiply 100 with 1.5 and 150 with 1. At support R, it has been lifted with 1 unit, right? So what is your answer? 150 into 1 plus 100 into, what is the coordinate of 100? Corresponding coordinate 1.5, right? So your answer is nothing but 300 kilonewton. Now let us see the last option, in which I am keeping my 150 kilonewton at this end point and 100 kilonewton is in air. So you just have to multiply 150 into, what was the corresponding coordinate?
you can see the corresponding coordinate was 1.5. So into 1.5, you will be getting 225 kilonewton. So what is the maximum? 300 or 225? Obviously 300. So my answer for the maximum reaction is 300 kilonewton and minimum is minus 30 kilonewton. So your right answer is 300 kilonewton and minus 30 kilonewton, option A. This question was asked in gate examination. Okay, so I have explained you, so I took lot of time, right? But in examination, when you are solving this question, it will be very simple. You can solve this in 2 minutes. Okay, now let us go to ILD for shear force at any section. Super important again. So all three are important: ILD for reactions, shear force and bending moment. Now let us see, if I want to draw ILD for shear force at any section C, okay, what I have to do? First let me tell you roughly. So let this be my beam, and somewhere I have C point. Okay, let this be A, let this be B, and I have C point here. So first cut it. Okay, when you cut it, what you will be getting? You will be getting two separate members, one member and two members, right? Now rotate both members in clockwise direction. So how you will rotate? For example, if I have a beam like this, what you have to do? Let this be my section C. So cut the section, cut this section. So if you cut, you will be getting two sections like this, right? Okay, now rotate both in clockwise direction. So how will you rotate this in clockwise direction? Like this. And this one, how will you rotate this member in clockwise direction? Obviously you have to rotate like this, right? This will be your clockwise direction. Agreed? So this member clock, okay, if I show like this, it is again mirror, so you will be confused. See this on the paper. So first member to go clockwise, you have to rotate like this, right? Only then it will be called as clockwise. But this member, it has to be lifted up to be called as clockwise, right? Because clockwise direction is this. This will be your anti-clockwise direction. I hope you are clear now. Okay, so once you have lifted it up, you have to rotate it with the theta value of 1 by L. Okay, if the length, beam length is L, you have to rotate by theta value of 1 by L. That's it. So whatever the deflected shape you are getting, right, that is the ILD for shear force. Okay, very simple, right? There is nothing here. In the previous case, for the reaction, you have lifted the support by 1 unit. Here you are cutting the member and rotating it with the theta value of 1 by L in clockwise direction. Always remember it, super important point. Now let us read the theory and then I will explain you once again. Without removing the support at A and B, cut the beam at C and lift the beam such that theta A is equal to theta B is equal to 1 by L. The corresponding deflected shape of the beam itself is the ILD for shear force at C. Okay, so just the theory is the same which I have just explained. If you have a simply supported beam like this and this is your C point, what you have to do? You have to cut at C and you will be getting two members, right? So these two members should be rotated with the theta value of 1 by L. This member should also be rotated with the theta value of 1 by L. Okay, so these two thetas are in clockwise direction. Many people make the mistake. Okay, many people make the mistake. Give this point, I have written in the hard notes clearly, so give it 5 star. You should never forget it. Some people rotate it in anti-clockwise direction and they make a blunder. Okay, so always remember, both the thetas are in clockwise direction. So the deflected shape, whatever you will be getting, so that will be your shear force diagram. See, if I have cut here and rotated it with theta is equal to 1 by L, right? So what will be this coordinate? See, this length was A. This length was A. Let me erase this. This length is A, right? So what will be this distance? A divided by L, this coordinate. Similarly, what should be this coordinate? This distance was B. And you are rotating with theta is equal to 1 by L. This length will be nothing but B by L, right? Because L theta. So B into 1 by L here. So you will be getting B by L and similarly A by L. Okay. So this value, what you will be getting? 1 by A by L plus B by L, which is nothing but A plus B by L. A plus B is nothing but L, right? So you will be getting L by L is equals to 1. So sum of the coordinates at C is 1. Always remember, wherever section you are finding the shear force, the coordinate at that member is equals to 1. Okay. Because this value is A by L, this value is B by L. If you add both, you will be getting 1. Okay. And this note is very important. This note has been asked in many PSCs directly. What is this note? shear force under the point load is indeterminate. So make a bracket here and write supports also. It's not just point load, even at the supports it is indeterminate. Either we can determine the shear force at the left or right of it, okay, not exactly at the point of application of load. See, when I am talking about point of application of load, this reaction is also giving the load only, right? In a very general term, this is the load, this is the reaction. So both have equal significance. So you can't exactly find shear force at these points, at the point of application. You can find either to the right part or the left part, okay? You can find either to the left or right, okay? Not about a meter away. For example, if I have a beam like this, okay, I am just finding it in a micro distance part, okay? You can say if this beam is 100 meters, I am finding it at a distance of say 10 centimeters, okay? Only very small distance apart, so that we can consider whatever reaction, whatever shear force we are finding at this point is equivalent to the shear force at this load application point, okay? So very clear, right? No issues. Now let us see the question. This question I will explain you. Many people make a mistake here, so please concentrate. So I have told you we cannot find the shear force exactly at the point of application. We can find either to the left side or the right side of the application of the load. For here he is asking us what is the shear force at RHS of A. A is a support. So exactly at support we cannot find. We can find either at the left side or at the right side. Now let us try to find what is the shear force at the right side. So I have a member like this. It is an overhanging member, right? So I have a member like this. This is A, this is B, and I have an overhang at the both sides. Okay, so shear force at RHS of A. So to get shear force, what you have to do? We have to cut the member. Where you have to cut? You have to cut at RHS of A. Just, this is A point, just beside A, cut it. Okay, so let me enlarge this image. Okay, so this image, I am enlarging it. Okay, so what, how it will be? So it will be something like this. So this is my support A and here I have cut it. Okay, so this member, when I cut it, this will be my member 1 and this will be my member 2, right? So let me use different color so that you will be clear. Okay, so this is my member 2. I have cut it. So it became 2 members now. So member 1 you have to rotate clockwise and member 2 also you have to rotate clockwise. So rotate it clockwise. So if you have rotated member 2 clockwise, first of all you will be getting something like this. Agreed? Okay. You will be getting something like this because it was an overhang member. It was an overhang member and here I had some support B, right? So when I am rotating it, when I am rotating the member 2 by unit distance, I will be getting deflection curve something like this. Agreed? Okay. Now again this member which is on the right side, again the member which is on the right side, what you have to do? You have to rotate clockwise only. So rotate it clockwise. So you will be getting something like this. Agreed. So this is your shear force diagram. So this is your shear force diagram. Many people confusing this diagram. I hope you are clear now. Let us see the diagram again and you will be perfect. So many people now they get confused. Sir, you are cutting at the point A. Okay, so you are lifting this clockwise. So obviously people get confused how to lift this remaining part. What they do is they, instead of lifting above, most of the people they go like this. Okay, instead of lifting up, they bend it down. So it is a very big blunder. I hope you are very clear, right? I have explained you very clearly why it should go up. Okay, so you are cutting the member. If this is the support you are cutting, just beside A. Okay, both these supports should be lifted in a clockwise direction. So this member, when you are lifting, it will be something like this. Agreed? This member. Okay, this also should be rotated clockwise, right? So rotate it clockwise. So this deflected shape will be your shear force diagram. I hope it is very clear. Okay, so you got the shape. Now read the text, you will be 100% clear. Okay, so without removing the support at A and B, cut the beam at RHS of A. Lift the beam such that theta A is equals to theta B is equals to 1 by A. Okay, if you are cutting to the RHS of A, that is this side, right? that is this side. So what should be your L? Your L should be the distance between these two supports. Okay, if you are cutting to the LHS of A, so what should be your distance? Your distance L should be L by 4. Agreed? Simple and logic. Then the deflected shape of the beam is ILD for shear force for the RHS of A. I hope you are perfect in this. Now let us solve the problem directly. Okay, after solving this problem, I will end the module, because the next module I will teach you ILD for bending moment at any section C. It has 4 subsections. Okay, bending moment is very important topic and it has 4 subsections. If I continue bending moment in the same module now, so there will be a break. So in this module I can teach only one part, and again in the next module I have to teach 3 parts. So it will be getting clumsy. So let us take all the bending moment ILDs in one module, which will be module number 18. Okay, so module number 17, let us conclude by solving this problem. So in this problem he is asking us to draw ILD for shear force. So the beam shown in the figure is subjected to moving distribution load of 4 kN per meter. Okay, so I have a beam. He has already given the question. So there is a load of 4 kN per meter acting, and this is the beam. Okay, you can see here I have an internal hinge, and again I have an internal hinge here. Okay, very good. Maximum shear force that can occur just to the right side of you. So here he is asking to find that. So what you have to do? You have to cut the member and rotate clockwise with the theta value of 1 by L. 1 by L yani here it is in between Q and R, right? So your theta value will be 1 by 20. I hope it is clear, right? Now rotate both the members 1 by 20 in clockwise direction. Okay, so when I cut the member, this first I will be getting something like this. So I have cut the member, I have got this member like this. Okay, so this member, what I have to do? I have to rotate clockwise. So here at this point I have to rotate it clockwise with respect to support Q. So what I will be getting? I will be getting shape something like this. Agreed? Because I have a hinge here, right? So whenever you are rotating this, okay, let me show you like this. So this is your member. So you are rotating the member, so obviously your hinge will go on. This point you have a support Q, it is not going anywhere. Only the hinge, whenever you are rotating clockwise, so it was initially perfectly straight. When you are rotating clockwise, your hinge will go up. You can imagine this, right? So I hope you are okay. Okay, so here to show you I have taken this much depth, but we are taking just to the right of, just on the right side of Q, right? So you can't actually represent, you can just take it like a point set, 0.mm apart. Okay, now this member 2, again you have to rotate clockwise. How much? 1 by 20. So lift it, you will be getting something like this. So here again I have the hinge at the point, right? Obviously it is like 2 members. So you are lifting one side. So what will happen? Obviously when you are lifting, this hinge pull apart will go down, right? Because this is acting as one member, right? And up to hinge one member, after hinge it is like one member. So when it is going up, you can't lift this point. So when you are lifting it, obviously what will happen? Your hinge is trying to go down. So your hinge will go down. And at this location your hinge is going up, at this location your hinge is going down. I hope you are perfect in this diagram. I hope you have understood this diagram. If you don't, just watch the diagram twice, thrice and be perfect in this. Okay. So I hope you are perfect in this diagram. If you have some doubt, please let me know through mail. I will explain again. Okay. Because this concept is so important. You should not lose your marks here. So what should be the coordinate here? Can you tell me what is the coordinate? Coordinate will be obviously 1, right? Because this coordinate is negligible. I am just taking at the right side, right hand side of it. Very negligible value. So I can take it as 1. Okay. So this is 20 meters and I am rotating it with theta is equals to 1 by 20. So what should be this distance? 20 into 1 by 20, which is equals to 1. Very clear, right? So what you have to do? You have to just find what is the maximum shear force. Okay. Once you got the ILD for shear force diagram, think about the multiple possibilities where you should keep your distributed load to get your maximum value. So obviously if you keep here, right, so you have some negative value. So let us think about it later on. But here in this part, I have only positive value and my highest coordinate is also in this section. So let me apply my force, my load in this section. So what I will be getting? So I have 4 kN acting up to point R, na? Yeah. So just multiply your load, 4 kN and these two areas. Okay, so what should be the answer? 4 kN into area of triangle 1, area of triangle 1. So how much is this distance? Can you tell me what is this distance? First of all, this distance is 10 meters, right? So I know 10 meters of BH, right? Of, I know the base, what is the height? So you should, you know, theta is equals to 1 by 20. So it has gone 5 meters. So obviously this height is nothing but 5 into 1 by 20, you will be getting 1 by 4. 1 by 4. This is of the triangle 1. Now of the triangle 2. So what is the area of triangle of base? Base was 20 meters, right? This length is 20 meters. Into what is the height? Height is very simple. We have just seen it is 1. We have calculated, right? It is 1. Or you can say 1 by 20 into 20. We will be getting 1. This is 20 and theta was 1 by 20. So multiply both, you'll be getting the coordinate which is 1. So this is your answer. So 4 into 10 by 8. 10 by 8 is 1.25, right? Plus 20 by 2, which is 10. So you will be getting 21.25. Let me erase this. 10 plus 1.25. 11.25 into 4, which is 45 kN. So that is your maximum value of shear force at this end, at this support Q. Okay, at the right hand side of the support Q. So this ends the module here. I hope you learned something or something in this module, and in next module it is going to be a very interesting, as well as there is lot of things you have to learn in the module number 18. So please concentrate well in the module number 18. I hope you are perfect in module number 17. If you have any doubts, please mail me and start practicing the problems related to this chapter. Okay. If you have some doubts, you can obviously ask me. I will help you. Okay. Have a nice day. See you in the module number 18.